Grace Farrell and you're watching The 86th Floor. Well, after an extremely long wait, Game of Thrones is back on our screens and the first episode of Series 5 aired on Sunday. So we're going to do a little review and tell you what we thought. Now, we are aware that episodes have been leaked, but we're only going to be reviewing episodes that have already been on HBO so far. If you need to recap on anything that's happened so far in Game of Thrones before you watch this episode, I suggest you follow this link and watch our epic recap song, which summarizes everything that's happened in Game of Thrones into a jolly song with a banjo. So it's called The Wars to Come, and this title could refer to any number of wars that are going on in Game of Thrones at the moment. Stannis is obviously against Rhys Bolton and pretty much everyone else as well. The Lannisters are against everyone. Everyone hates the Lannisters. Daenerys Targaryen is at war with slavery, and also I'm sure she will soon be at war with Westeros to take the throne. And of course the Wildlings are at war with everyone else. And last but not least, the magical people, the White Walkers, and also the zombie skeleton warriors that we saw at the end of Series 4 are soon to be at war with all the humans. So a lot of people are at war. Speaking of the magical war element, I did think it was strange that Bran, Hodor and Meera weren't shown at all in this episode, especially since the last time we saw them, they only narrowly escaped the skeleton warriors. So it would have been nice to just see how they're getting on, you know? But although we didn't actually get to see a scene with them in it, we saw a scene that echoed the penultimate scene of Series 4. It was a flashback, the first flashback that's ever been in Game of Thrones, and it was of Cersei as a young child. Now, the way that scene was filmed was, I thought, very similar to the scene in which Bran enters the cave and sees the three-eyed eagle who tells him that he won't walk again but that he will fly. So Cersei, a young child Cersei, in the flashback enters a cave and sees a woman and says, "You're supposed to be terrifying. You're supposed to have cat's teeth and three eyes." Now, is the three eyes referring to the three-eyed raven? Because the man who talked to Bran said, "I've been many different forms." So was he in fact the woman that spoke to Cersei in this scene? And if so, why are we seeing Cersei's exchange with it? I say it because obviously it's had many different forms. It's interesting because we don't find anything new, unless I'm missing something, in this flashback. Cersei asks three questions to the fortune teller. She says, "Will I marry a prince?" And the fortune teller says, "No, but you will marry a king," obviously King Robert. She says, "Will I be queen?" She says, "You will be queen, but then another younger, more beautiful queen will come and take your place," obviously referring to Margaery. And then she says, "Will the king and I have children?" And this is a great line. The fortune teller goes, "No, Robert will have 20 children," obviously referring to his bastard children. And then she says, "And you will have three. And they'll have gold crowns." So any theories you have on this scene and why we're being shown it, especially why we're being shown the first flashback ever, would be warmly welcomed. I would assume that it's going to have some sort of importance later on. So back to the episode. In King's Landing, everyone's mourning the death of Tywin Lannister. And Lancel Lannister turns up, and I thought he was actually a new character that was just being introduced in this episode, but of course it's Lancel, who Cersei's cousin, who she was sleeping with earlier on, but he looks unrecognizable. He's put on quite a lot of weight and he's cut his hair really short. It's completely unrecognizable, so that did confuse me for a few minutes. He has found a new religion and calls himself a sparrow. So it's interesting to see yet another bird reference. And it will be interesting to see whether this religion plays a role in this season. I suspect it will. Meanwhile, Tyrion has been transported to Essos in a crate with Varys. And Varys says to Tyrion that it's basically their responsibility to save Westeros and to find a ruler who's stronger than Tommen, but gentler than Stannis, who has a load of followers and comes from a good family name. And Tyrion goes, "Well, good luck finding him." And then Varys goes, I didn't say anything about him. Obviously talking about Daenerys Targaryen. So it looks like in this season, they're going to go and meet up with her and join her mission. I'm wondering if this will finally be the season. Finally be the season that Daenerys actually crosses the Narrow Sea and starts a war in Westeros. She's not having the best time in Meereen, is old Daenerys, because one of her dragons is still missing and the other two keep trying to attack her. And also the people that she saved seem to want to go back to their slave life. Meanwhile, at the Wall, Stannis is now ruling, and his plan is to convince Mance, who rules the Wildlings, to join his army so that they can defeat Roose Bolton and rule the North together. And he says that they'll be able to live south of the Wall if they do that. It should be noted that the one major death of episode one does happen at the Wall, so I'm not going to say too much more. So in another thread of the narrative, Peter Baelish and Sansa seem to be in a relationship now, and Sansa's dyed her hair, I think, which makes her look... I don't know whether it's supposed to imply that she's a slightly darker character now, because obviously she's with Baelish, who everyone knows is evil. They're seen leaving the Vale, and Baelish says to Sansa, "We're going somewhere so far away that Cersei won't be able to get her hands on you." Which I thought was weird, because I thought that he'd stay in the Vale and try and establish a power base there. One other thing I thought was noteworthy was Margaery's character, who also seems to be a bit darker. Perhaps Cersei's character's rubbing off on her. At one point, Loras says to her, "If I don't go to Highgarden and marry Cersei, you're going to be stuck with her here." And Margaery goes, "Perhaps," twice. I mean, what could that mean? Is she actually suggesting that she might kill Cersei? I suspect that this season could focus primarily on Stannis, Margaery and Cersei, but I could be wrong. Do let us know what you thought of the wars to come in the comments below, and join us for our next review.
Hello YouTube, we're Anime K, and this is all four seasons of Game of Thrones in one song. There's a wall, a few asshole families, and one very uncomfortable chair.